Hi and welcome or welcome back to my channel Modern Modiste. In today's video I'm going to be making a puffer jacket. If you didn't see my first puffer quilt that I made on this channel a while back, go and check that out. I'll link it in the video or in the description box. But yes, today I'm going to be making another puffer, only this one's going to be lightweight and more suit for transitioning into spring weather. I'm going to be using this puffer from H&M as inspiration. So if you look close, you can see that there's some gathering here within those stitches. I love that detail. I think it looks super cute. I love that it's a crop jacket. And this will be the last winter-like project I'm gonna make because I don't wanna encourage winter to stay any longer. After this, I'm gonna start switching over to spring colors and spring projects because we need spring to come. Yeah. Let's get to it. So here are the fabric cuts that we'll need to make this puffer jacket. I made this pattern chasing a very oversized sweatshirt I have and then cropping it. I'm going to do some gathering across these pieces, so I made sure to have the extra room in my pattern. I cut two fronts and marked my lines. For this project, I'm going to be using some fiberfill, and I'm going to be using this, which I already opened, so I'm just going to show you the empty bag. Some polyfill quilt batting, and I got the extra loft one. I went and gathered my lines and added my welt pocket to one half of the front just for some off-camera practice. I cut one layer of my quilt batting to match each of my fronts. I cut 1.5 inches from the bottom of the batting so that it wouldn't be in the way later when creating the elastic casing. I pinned my batting to my fabric, and now I'm going to sew a stitch across the shoulder, around the neckline, and down the front edge. Then I'm going to sew a basting stitch along the two lines I marked, back stitching one end but not the other, and leaving enough thread on the end, not back stitch, to pull together. I wanted to extend the width of the sleeve to give myself some more gathering room. To do that, I folded my pattern in half and traced it onto my fabric. Then, I folded the opposite way and moved the bottom edge over 4 inches, which added this triangular-shaped amount of extra fabric without extending the shoulder curve. I marked my lines and cut a single layer of batting for each sleeve. I pinned the batting to my fabric. I'm going to sew along half of the edge, leaving the other half open to feed the polyfill into, and again sew basting stitch across the lines to gather. This is what the results will be. For the back with my fabric folded, I marked my pattern about 1 inch from the fold to give some room for gathering and raise the neckline. Then I cut it out with a matching layer of batting. I pinned the batting to my back fabric and marked my lines. Again, I'm going to sew along the neckline, one shoulder, armhole, and side, and then sew basting stitches along my marked lines to gather. For the back, I also sewed the basting stitch along a neckline to gather in the extra inches that were added there too. I separated the top thread from the bottom and pulled it together along the two marked lines, and then filled with batting until I was content with the puffiness. Then I added polyfill to my front and began to pull the thread on my basting stitches to gather. My thread broke while I was trying to gather the front, so I finished adding my polyfill, and then I scrunched it with my hands at the sewing machine, and I just sewed over the line to give a gathered effect like this. Next, it was time to add the welt pocket. There are some great welt pocket tutorials here on YouTube if you need a detailed tutorial on sewing the welt pockets. But yeah, I marked the length and width I wanted my welt pocket to be onto the fabric and pinned it to the front. Here are my pocket bag pieces,
And for the welt part of this welt pocket, I cut a rectangular fabric and a piece of batting to sandwich between it. I sewed along the rectangular edge. I cut along the center line and along the two triangle edges. I cut the excess batting from the edge and turned the edges of this piece to the inside of the jacket and pinned it in place. I'm going to sew around the edge and sew the batting into the welt piece along the bottom edge. Next, I pinned my welt to the opening along the short sides and the bottom edge and sewed it into place. Then I sewed the pocket back pieces to the welt and sewed the pocket sides together along the edge. So I also sewed along the gathered lines on the back to keep my gathers in place. Then I clipped the fronts to the back at the shoulders and sewed them together. Next is time to pin on the sleeve. I gathered my sleeves along the marked lines and filled them with polyfill. I went and stitched over my gathered lines to keep my gathers in place and trimmed any excess batting along the edges. I pinned the sleeve to my armhole, lining up the center of the sleeve with the shoulder seam. After I sewed the sleeves on, I clipped the sides together to try on the jacket to see if I was happy with how much polyfill I added before sewing the sides closed, and ended up removing a lot of polyfill.
And like I said, this jacket that I'm making is more geared toward the ending of winter and transitioning into spring. So I'm not aiming to make it super thick and super warm like I did my other puffer coat. This one's just going to be light and cute and a nice jacket to transition into spring.
Once I was happy with my feeling, I pinned the sides closed at the armpits and down the sides and sleeves. I sewed from the armpits down the sides and from the armpits down the sleeves. Next, I measured my neckline and cut out my neckline pieces. Normally, I'd cut two pieces front and back, but I had to cut out the pieces with the remaining of my fabric, so I ended up cutting four pieces, two for the front and two for the back neckline. I cut the neckline to be an inch shorter in the back than in the front. Then I sewed each half of the pieces together along the short edge and pressed open the seam. I cut a piece of batting to match and sewed the batting around the entire perimeter on one half and along the short and top edge of the other to fill in that side with polyfill. Once I filled it with polyfill, I sewed the bottom edge of the batting to the fabric. I pinned the neckline piece filled with polyfill to the neckline of my jacket and sewed it in place. Once my collar was attached, I marked an inch and a half from the bottom where the bottom edge would fold up and clipped half my zipper to one edge right sides facing and sewed it onto my jacket using a zipper foot. Then I marked the neckline and my lines on the other half of the zipper and pinned it to the other side of my jacket, lining up the marks with the lines. Once the two sides of my zipper were sewn on, I assembled the lining the same way I assembled the jacket. After I finished my lining, I clipped my lining to my jacket along the top edge and along the bottom edge. I sewed the two together. With my jacket right side out, I pulled the lining and jacket sleeve inside out and sewed the opening edges together. The bottom edge of the jacket sleeve is wider than the lining sleeve's edges, so the bottom of the jacket sleeve needs to be gathered first to match the width, then sewed together. To create the elastic casing, I pinned the bottom edge up 1.5 inches. I sewed the line right there where I pinned it. I used a safety pin to help guide my elastic through the casing and sewed each edge of the elastic in place about 1.5 inches from the zipper edges. To finish the jacket, I turned it back wrong side out and sewed the lining edge to the zipper edge along one side and halfway down the other. I clipped the excess zipper and fabric from the corners, then I pulled the jacket through the half I didn't sew. Last, I top stitched along the edges of the zipper, closing the opening I left on the one side, and that completes this project. If you're not digging the super wide collar, all you have to do is lift up the neckline when you make this jacket, and that'll give you a smaller collar. Thank you for watching. I hope you enjoyed the video. If you did, be sure to like, subscribe. But yeah, stay tuned because I'm back and I'm ready for all the spring projects that are coming. Bye.